can't believe it. The Emerald City.
Man, we finally made it through.
Now, all we've got to do is stand for it.
And the lion?
Come on, move it.
To meet the wizard. Trade them for a beautiful emerald wizard ring.
Oh, no, I can't. I made a promise to keep them on until I get home.
Break it?
No, I was taught to never break the promise.
You know, I can understand why a child like you wanting to go to Brazil, Mozambique, but Birmingham. Did I hear you correctly? Birmingham.
Yes, sir.
And what's wrong with it here?
Nothing.
Does my fantastic emerald city displease you?
No, it's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. It was home. Aunt Emma for Henry. I can't get her back in Canada.
You may do whatever you want. Besides, what's a home but broken furniture, faded memories and shattered dreams? Why not forget it? Lion, what do you want?
To get the hell out of here. Help!
Is that your only request?
Yes, sir, and I agree. What's a home but broken furniture, faded memories and cold oatmeal? Oh, if only you knew my mama.
But what is it you want?
Some courage.
You're telling me that the mighty king of the jungle is a coward?
Only when I'm scared.
Weakness. That's your only strength. Scarecrow, are you afraid of anything, too? Are you a coward, too?
Coward. Oh, no, sir. I haven't got the brains to be afraid of anything.
No.
Except for fire.
Not afraid of anything? How little we know ourselves. Tell me, which is more deceptive, the foolish wise man or the wise fool?
The foolish wise man or the wise fool? Don't ask me, I was never any good at multiple choice.
Why, you dumb sack of straw. Tin Man, what do you want?
From a heart, your wisdom.
A heart? What for? Without one, you'll never feel pain or hurt or sorrow.
Well, isn't there more to feelings than just that?
Well, yeah, but is it really worth the suffering?
I'll check my chances, your witness. I'll check my chances. Now, will you help me get heart or not?
Will you lay off the witness business? Now, I have made my decision. I'll get you a heart. I'll get you some brains. I'll get you some courage. And I'll get Dorothy back to Canvas. If
what?
If you kill the most evil, the most wicked, the most powerful of all the witches in Oz, the Wicked Witch of the West.
But I couldn't do something like that.
Why not? You've already killed one Wicked Witch.
But that was an accident. Stop using my past against me.
Your past is my future.
How?
With the witch dead, I'll be the ultimate authority.
I know someone who can defeat the fat.
Dorothy, don't stir up the witness.
Mm-hmm. What do I have to do to get my brain?
Kill the Wicked Witch of the West, of course.
You just told Dorothy she had to do that.
It doesn't matter who does it, this is a package deal. As long as the Wicked Witch of the West still lives, none of you gets anything.
What kind of God would ask someone for?
He's not God, he's the Wiz.
Look, Dorothy, if you want to get back to Bromley's badly, you're just going to have to pay for it.
My dad paid my debts.
Say what?
Mr. Wiz, please.
No! I have spoken.
Make way for the Wicked Witch of the West. Make way for evening.
Oh, we believe! Oh, we believe!
Shut up! Because I'm evil with everyone today.
Bad news.
mostly?
Well, firstly, Dorothy and her friends are still on their way up yet, and they're gonna be here.
What?
No, you
can't. You're fat now. But that, I'm having your fight. any water, holy water from holy hands.
Holy water? You can't have all been told. I merely just stood up to injustice. That's all you had to do this entire time. She bewitched me to believe in the sheer power of you. Without you realising the power God has put in each and every one of you.
So, what just happened here? Kids, was the enemy was dirty and just needed to be... Leave the money and go.
Money? What money?
You see, we brought back this big bag of loot for the Wiz. How much do you think is in here for the lion?
Bag? What bag? Oh. Well, between the gold and the silver alone, I'd say somewhere in the vicinity of around 50.
I'd say there's at least twice that much.
So, when the man did the keys, in and the money will be right here in front of the garbage chute. Come on, Dorothy, we've got to be going before it gets dark. Gold? Silver? Where?
Gotcha!
A foot, oh God, I fall for this every time. Every time.
We're going to see the wind.
Alright then, but I thought we'd be there when you wake up. Look with your eyes and not with your hands.
Strange voice.
Well, I can't swear whether it was live or on tape, but I heard it as clear as a bell. Well, the next day, I read where 500 folk were going to get together for a county fair.
And?
So I rented myself a hot air balloon.
Why?
Check this out. I come floating out of the clouds. I lay my maiden message on the multitude. Then I rip out the granddaddy of all revival meetings. Now, unfortunately, as I was coming out from over the carousel, a violent windstorm came up. And before I knew it, I was drifting over some huge desert someplace. And as an opening in the clouds came, I drifted through and landed right here in Oz, right in the middle of a ladies' social.
Come, Mr. Wiz. What happened next, Mama?
Well, these ladies had never seen a hot air balloon before, and they thought a miracle had delivered me to them. So before you could say wizard, they promoted me all over town and sold tickets for a benefit, at which they said I was going to perform my next miracle at. Naturally, I did.
And what miracle would that be?
Green glasses.
Green glasses?
Yeah, green glasses, like the ones everyone's wearing. Like, just like the pair I was wearing when I landed here.
But Mr. Wiz, there ain't no big deal about a pair of green shades, is there?
Look, Lion, the miracle is that they believe they can see something through them. You have to believe in your heart. So you do believe you have a brain, don't you?
Well, I'd feel a whole lot better if I knew there wasn't anything besides just your stairs.
You know what? If I could find a bunch of green glasses out there, I'm pretty sure I could find something in here for you. Ah, here we are. All brain, through the miracle of modern science, they have dehydrated, pre-frozen, pre-packaged the distillation of some of the world's best brains. We're going to restuff your head with this.
Oh, finally! I know where my head is at!
A heart, you say?
Yes.
Then a heart it shall be. You know once, a young lady gave her heart to me, and now I give it to you.
Are the batteries included?
And no extra charge.
All you fine ladies out there, you better watch out.
As for you, Jack, I bet a couple of totes of the Emerald City courage potion will do the trick.
Alright. Alright.
Just stop. Can't you guys see what's happening? You're putting your beliefs in things that have no power. Green glasses, cereal, heart necklace, and a potion. You said you heard the voice of the Almighty to spread the good news. Well, so did I. But you're going about this all the wrong way. Do you really think you have anything to do with this? What's your vote?
Look, Dorothy, I'm sorry. I can do a lot of things for a lot of people, but I just can't get you back to work. The answer's just not in the box.
You don't say. It is an endless stream of gossip.
Of course it's not. Out there. Tell me, my good fellow, you still have that hot air balloon?
Yes. The ladies put it in the park as a national shrine.
Now, if that air balloon got you from Walls to here, why couldn't they take Dorothy back to Brom?
Why, it certainly could.
When are we going to go?
Oh, you're not going to get me to leave all of this.
All of what?
Well, my power, prestige and money.
You mean this big old empty room where no one ever comes to visit you? And you're too afraid to go outside unless people find out you're falling then?
I'm not afraid. I just keep a low profile.
I bet you could do all this in someplace else. And you could even have some friends.
Friends? You really think so?
Look, it's so bad once someone gets to know you.
Friends? Huh? Well, what are we waiting for?
Wait, Mr. Wiz. I feel like we're doing God a disservice if we need to not be in the cabin. You have to spread the news to all the nations.
So what do you want me to do?
Deliver.
Say, my friends, on this memorable day when friends must part, remember, to everything there is a season, and a time to keep, and a time to cast away.
Yes!
I said a time to keep!
Yes!
A time to cast away!
Yes!
I said a time to keep!
Yes!
I said a time to keep!
Yes!
A time to remember! actually holding us down! Down! Not to reach up! Down! Afraid to wade through strange and turbulent waters! Down! Burning in the heat of your own lies, when you ought to be reaching up, 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 up! To reach the frozen fingers of truth, you've got to peel off your clothes to find out who you truly are. You're gonna do it? Shall I do it?
Yes!
Oh, I have done it! I have stepped outside of myself.
Step!
In order to dig into my own soul.
Step!
In order to see what I ought to have seen before.
Step! Step!
It is not enough to know where you are coming from. You also have to know where you are going to.
Thank the Lord. Well.
I told you about my sister, Glinda. She's the prettiest of all us witches. Takes after me.
So can she get Glinda back to Rome?
Oh, don't worry. I'll bring Glinda here before you can say great googie meega sugar booga. Just the way with my magic hanky. Listen, that's Glinda.
are coming out of the woodwork. Go ahead, Linda. Work your show, baby.
Even met me.
If you even met any of us.
but it definitely wouldn't have been a shame. So, I've never known if you've got your heart, if you've got your brain, and you, Lion. Dorothy, do you really have to go?
Well, logically, she should come back whenever she wanted.
And I will stand for it, I promise. But why not? Don't you see?
Showers home, I was showers back.
that not just entertain but empower. We obviously want to give them opportunities to sing and dance, but we want to give them an opportunity to minister as well. We don't want anyone to go home without feeling like they've had some kind of, you know, message being delivered to them in a way. So before you leave, I just want to kind of just go through some of the hidden messages within the Wiz. And it's something that we, Cast 1 and Cast 2, we both sat down and we dug into these characters. What does it mean? Because sometimes we watch TV and we watch this and so on, and sometimes we miss things or we don't understand things. And we are a faith-based organisation, and we like to ensure that we understand what we're doing. We don't just perform for the sake of performing. So just a little bit of background to the Wiz and what the Wiz-Revelation, which we're calling it. All these characters represent someone or something, something that we've probably all gone through in life. The main character is the Scarecrow. He's a character that had no brain, but realistically he did have a brain. It's just, it's a point where he was told he wasn't good enough, or he had a job, he had a business, but he failed at some points, and that kind of made him defeated in a way that he couldn't do anything. And really, actually, he did actually say some very logical things. Well, she actually said a lot of logical things in the production. And so it's those people that tell you that, you're not good enough or whatever. So that's who the Scarecrow represents. And you've got the Lion. The Lion didn't have any courage. At the start, when he first came on, he talked about him not having a father at home, and he's just being abandoned. So he was the mama's boy. And, you know, that courage that he wanted, that strength that he needed, he didn't learn that. So he's had to try and learn it himself. And you've got characters like the Tin Man, who changed his whole persona just because he wanted to be loved, but then he didn't really love himself because he hasn't experienced love or he didn't have anyone to love. And you've got the characters such as the Munchkins, who represent the non-believers, who try and divert your path, and you know where you're going, but you've got these people that come into your life and try and take you all around the beacon, basically, not really focus on where you're supposed to be. And obviously you've got our Dorothy, who really wants a purpose in life, and she knows what God's called her to do, and God's put her in a position where she can be that influencer, where she can make a difference, and she's succeeding in doing that. And obviously you've got the evil witch, who's trying to keep everybody down, even though they had nothing to be scared of or didn't speak for water on her. So don't try to see anyone. You know what I mean? So, and then obviously you've got the Wiz, and the Wiz is a very important character because he represents someone who's in authority, who had used his own authority. He was entrusted with a vision. He said in his monologue that he heard the voice of the Almighty speak to him, but obviously he's misinterpreted because he thought it was about power, prestige and money, and he's abused his authority, and people are worshipping a man and not, you know, God and not the spirit. So all these characters have represented, and I hope you guys got something from that. And even the things that the Wiz took out his box to help soothe people, to help them think that. So we use cereal, so people go to food to kind of, you know, console them. We'll go to drink. So she wasn't drinking alcohol, it was nothing, you know. Okay, and obviously materialistic things, and those things will only keep us happy for the moment. But there's something deep within inside that will last a lifetime if we believe in ourselves and if we trust in a higher purpose and a higher calling, and obviously God the Father, which we want to kind of teach to you guys so that you guys go out. So I really hope you guys have got that. And